In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet Midsegment of a Triangle. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Now, the midsegment of a triangle is the segment that connects the midpoints of two sides. So let's call this triangle, triangle ABC. The midsegment of a triangle is a segment that connects the midpoints of two separate sides. So if I find the midpoint between A and B, and I find the midpoint between A and C, and then connect the two, that is a midsegment. So let's say that X is the midpoint between A and B, and Y is the midpoint between A and C. So XY, that segment, is the midsegment. And an important theorem that we're going to use in this worksheet is the triangle midsegment theorem. The triangle midsegment theorem states that the midsegment is parallel to the third side. So since XY was the midsegment related to sides AB and AC, then that XY is going to be parallel to BC. And you can see, remember, parallel lines go in the same direction, never intersecting. So that's the first part of the midsegment triangle theorem. The second part is that that midsegment XY is equal to half of the distance from B to C. So the length of this midsegment XY is 1/2 times the length of the third side that it's parallel to, BC. Knowing those two separate parts, let's get started on this worksheet. In number 1 and 2, it says in each triangle, M, N, and P are the midpoints of the sides. Name a segment parallel to the one given. So M, N, and P are the midpoints, and we're looking at this side CD. We need to figure out which segment CD is parallel to. Well, notice that CD is the side of one of the triangles. So in order to find a segment that's parallel to it, we need to find a midsegment of the other two sides. So the midpoint of side DE is N, the midpoint of side CE is P, so the midsegment is segment PN, and we know by the triangle midsegment theorem that segment PN will be parallel to CD. So segment CD is parallel to segment PN, or you could say segment NP. In number 2, we're looking for what is parallel to segment QS. Here is segment QS. That is one side of a triangle, so we need to find the midpoint of the other two sides. So side SR, the midpoint is N, side RQ, the midpoint is M, and when we connect those two, we will get the midsegment. And we know that the midsegment relating to two sides is parallel to that third side. So MN is parallel to QS. So segment MN is parallel to QS. In the next part of this worksheet, we're finding the missing length indicated. And remember, the midsegment is half the length of the side that it's parallel to. So in number 3, we're finding the length of segment CD, this segment here. We can see that point C is the midpoint of side XY and point D is the midpoint of side ZY because this is congruent to this, so they're the same length, so this is the halfway point, and this is congruent to this, so this is the midpoint. And remember, the midsegment is parallel to that third side, which in our case is this side with length of 16. So the midsegment, CD, is equal to half the length of the side it's parallel to, which in our case is XZ, which has a length of 16. So CD is equal to 1/2 times 16, or 16 divided by 2, which is 8. So 8 is the solution in number 3. In number 4, we're finding the length of AC, which is this segment here. Again, we can see that T is the midpoint of AB, S is the midpoint of CB, therefore TS is a midsegment, and the third side that it's parallel to is that AC. So the midsegment TS is equal to half the length of the third side of the triangle, which is AC. So knowing that TS is 4, we'll plug 4 in for TS, and that's equal to 1/2 AC, and we're solving for AC, so all we'll do is multiply by 2 in order to cancel out that 1/2. So 8 is equal to AC. In number 5, we're asked to find KJ. KJ is the midsegment regarding sides AB and BC, since K and J are the midpoints of AB and BC respectively. So we know that KJ is going to be equal to 1/2 of that third side that it also happens to be parallel to, which is 18. So KJ equals 1/2 of 18, which is 9. So 9 is our solution in number 5. We're finding IK. In this problem, SR is the midsegment, since S is the midpoint of KJ and R is the midpoint of IJ. So SR equals 1/2 the length of this third side, IK. And we know that SR is 5, so 5 is equal to 1/2 IK. So we're going to multiply both sides by 2 to cancel out that 1/2. 2 times 5 is 10, so 10 is our solution in number 6. 10 is the length of IK. In number 7, we're finding the length of DF. We know that VU is the midsegment, since V is the midpoint of DE, U is the midpoint of EF, and the third side is DF. So VU and DF are not only parallel, but VU equals 1/2 the length of DF. And since VU is 9, that's equal to 1/2 the length of DF. So when we multiply by 2, 2 times 9 is 18, so 18 is equal to DF in number 7. And the last problem I'll go over in this video, number 8. However, before I go over the answer to this, please remember to click that subscribe button. And while you're clicking that, go ahead and click the thumbs up as well. Now, in number 8, we're asked to find PQ. PQ, we can see, is that mid-segment. Q is the midpoint of TS, P is the midpoint of TU, and the side that's parallel to, then, will be US. And in this problem, note that it gives us extraneous information. We don't need to know that this segment QS is 7, and we also don't need to know that this segment UT is 32. We're finding PQ, so you can disregard that extraneous information, and we have that PQ, the midsegment, is equal to the third side of that triangle, which has a value of 30 US. So PQ equals 1/2 times 30, which is 15. So 15 is the final solution in this video. Join me in the next video where I'll finish the second page of this worksheet. And if you didn't do so before we completed number 8, go ahead and click that subscribe button. And if you have any questions, please leave a comment below.